Very good morning, children. This is a small overview of the chapter Microorganism Friend and Foe. Tomorrow you all have your doubt clearing classes, so we have already done worksheets and study material on this, but this is just a small recapitulation of the whole chapter. Microorganisms, we cannot see them with your naked eyes, and they are definitely seen under a microscope. Major classified into your four major groups. One are the bacteria, fungi, protozoa and algae, and there are viruses also which reproduce only inside the host organism. COVID-19 is one of them. The ailments that they cause is your cold, influenza, and there are certain other serious diseases which they cause in your like polio, chickenpox are also caused by viruses. They have a different structure altogether other than bacteria, fungi, protozoa. And diseases like dysentery, malaria caused by protozoa, whereas typhoid and tuberculosis are bacterial diseases. These are your certain shapes of bacteria. Bacteria even in a spherical shape also you see. You see it in rod shape also. You see it in comma shaped also. You see it in spiral shaped also. Okay, bacteria are unicellular prokaryotic microorganisms. Fungi are saprophytic, they eat on dead and decaying matter. Algae are photosynthetic, they are green in color, they have chlorophyll, they can make their own food. Now, protozoa are single-celled, unicellular, and viruses, they are not considered as living and non-living. They are only capable of reproduction inside the host. Outside, they are not living. So some of the diagrams are here, pictures are here, spiral bacteria, rod-shaped bacteria. One example is lactobacillus, curd formation bacteria, curd-forming bacteria. Chlamydomonas and spirogyra are your algae. They are present in your pond, one green color covering if you see in your ponds, they are of this. Spirogyra, if you see it under the microscope, you will definitely see such structures. Amoeba is unicellular, these are pseudopodia of amoeba, paramecium is here. Bread mold, the fungi which grows on your bread, if you keep a moist bread, a green color covering is formed. Penicillin is responsible for your formation of your antibiotics. Viruses have very different structure. They have different structure from all other microorganisms. They don't have a very well-developed structure, but they are capable of only reproducing themselves and multiplying themselves inside the host. They take up the host machinery and then they work on it. For example, we are facing right now is coronavirus. Where do microorganisms live? Microorganisms can live in hot deserts, in springs, very hot places. They are omnipresent. They are capable of staying in very cold regions also and very hot regions also. Inside our body also, they are capable of living. There are many bacteria which are present in our human body. They help us also and some of them are very harmful. There are some of the microorganisms are very useful for us. For example, they help in soil fertility, fixing nitrogen. Example is rhizobium, cyanobacteria. Making of curd and bread. Curd contains several microorganisms of these bacterium. Lactobacillus promotes the formation of curd. A question can come. Name a microorganism helps in formation of curd. A yeast also helps in your baking industry because it's capable of production of carbon dioxide. And thus we see the breads and pastries, they swell up, they are swollen and they have pores on it because of your carbon dioxide production. Commercial use of microorganisms, yeast is used for production of alcohol and wine. And this smell of alcohol as sugar is converted into alcohol by yeast, this process is known as fermentation. It is in the absence of oxygen, and Louis Pasteur had discovered fermentation. Medicinal use, many antibiotics are formed. They stop the growth of disease-causing microorganisms. Examples are streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin. Alexander Fleming was working on culture of disease-causing bacteria, and he observed the presence of mold prevented the growth of bacteria. So from this, the mold penicillin was prepared. Okay, this is responsible for finding out an antibiotic. commonly known as antibiotics, which are made from fungi and bacteria. Antibiotics are made from fungi and bacteria. And the antibiotics are manufactured by growing specific microorganisms and are used to cure a variety of diseases. They are even used and even mixed to feed livestock and poultry. They also face some diseases. Antibiotics should be taken in the advice of a qualified doctor only. What are vaccines? Vaccines are produced if a dead and weakened microbe are introduced in a healthy body. The body fights and kills them by producing suitable antibodies. Okay? So Edward Jenner, he discovered a vaccine for smallpox, and thus now smallpox is eradicated. Even your cholera, tuberculosis, hepatitis, they are all prevented. What happens in this is a vaccine is a medicine that helps you to fight disease causing germs. Doctors give you these medicines well in advance so that when your body comes face to face with the dangerous germs, it can fight them. A vaccine contains a little bit of disease causing germ that is weak or dead. Since the germ has been killed or weakened, so what will happen? It does not make the person sick. When the person receives the vaccine, the body's defense system jumps. And so antibodies are made, which are known as the soldiers of your body. So now when the harmful germs will enter, they will not be able to survive there because your antibodies are already present. As just to make the antibodies active, dead or weakened germs are introduced in the body. Okay. Smallpox is eradicated, is not there anymore. Even pulse polio vaccine is there. Soil fertility, cyanobacteria is there, rhizobium is there. They are all useful bacteria. Cleaning of the environment is also done by the bacteria. Suppose you see a large amount of dead organic matter in the form of decaying plants, sometimes animals. And then you see them disappear. This is how, because microorganisms can feed on them and break these substances, and then they are not present anymore. They feed on these dead and decaying matter. So who feeds on them? The microorganism, especially some of the bacteria. Harmful microorganisms are ones which are known as pathogens. Pathogens are disease causing. They can cause us communicable diseases such as cholera, cold, chickenpox, tuberculosis. Okay, and when a person is suffering from common cold sneezes, fine droplets of moisture, thousands of viruses spread in air and they enter the healthy person. Next, we have some insects and animals are carriers of these microbes. They carry these microbes, like housefly is one example. Anopheles mosquito is an example, which carries the parasite of malaria. Female Aedes mosquito acts as a carrier of dengue virus. So these carry the microorganisms, and when they come in contact with human beings, we get affected. We should always not let water collection. It's because mosquitoes breed in water, and if mosquito is present, then you can get dengue or malaria. This table is important. I have already sent you this table. Please learn this table. It's an important table. Okay. Then there are some plant diseases also, which is caused by your microorganisms. Bacteria causes citrus canker. And fungi causes rust of wheat and wheat. Virus causes yellow vein mosaic of bhindi or okra. This table is important. Food poisoning, if we take any spoiled food or microorganisms, then it causes sickness in us. Food preservation is the way we preserve our food so that our food is not spoiled by microorganisms. There are various techniques to it. Chemical method is there. Salt and edible oils are used to check the growth of microorganisms. Sodium benzoate, sodium metabisulfate are added to check the spoilage. Common salt is added. to your food. Preservation by sugar is there. Sugar reduces moisture and inhibits the growth of bacteria. Preservation by oil and vinegar, because bacteria cannot live in such environment. So we put oil and vinegar, so your food will be preserved. Heat and cold treatments. Very important definition of pasteurization. Pasteurized milk can be consumed without boiling. The milk is heated for a particular temperature and suddenly it's chilled, and so your microbes die and they prevent the growth, and this was discovered by Louis Pasteur. Storage and packaging is done. They are stored in airtight containers. Nitrogen fixation is done by your fixation of nitrogen in leguminous plants. Rhizobium is a bacteria which lives in your root nodules, and it's a symbiotic relationship where both the plant and the bacteria are benefited. So let us understand how it happens. Nitrogen cycle, here is your atmospheric nitrogen, okay. This is through lightning and through your fixing bacteria, they all come into the soil. Actually, it is in free form, but your plant need it in your, and the soil is needed in your nitrate form. So they are all fixed by your nitrogen bacteria. Nitrogen bacteria or nitrogen fixing bacteria. Cyanobacteria is an example. Rhizobium is an example. So all of them, they fix it. Now when they fix it, it's present in the form of nitrates, is taken up by the plants. Now when these plants are eaten up by animals, again when the fecal matter is excreted, it again comes back to the soil. So again your nitrogen is coming back to the soil one more way. Okay, plants are taken up by plants, the plants are eaten, again this excreted, again it comes to the soil. But when it again comes to the soil, from again soil, it is again these bacteria from compounds of nitrogen into gaseous nitrogen. Again, some bacteria known as denitrifying bacteria, they break these nitrates and it again comes back here. So again, it is fixed from the atmosphere free form, it is fixed. Then from the fixed form, again it becomes free form. It is free form, fixed form, and again it is becomes free form. So this cycle is maintained, and so your atmosphere has 78% of nitrogen. Nitrogen is one of the essential constituents. So we cannot take up nitrogen like that from the air. So what happens through like this whole process, we are able to take nitrogen for the human body, for the animals are able to take it, because it is important for formation of proteins, chlorophyll, nucleic acid, vitamins. Certain bacteria and blue-green algae present in the soil fix the nitrogen. Once nitrogen is converted to usable form, it can be utilized. Nitrogen is then used for synthesis of plant proteins. Animals feeding on plants get these proteins and other nitrogen compounds. When plants and animals die, bacteria and fungi present in the soil convert the nitrogen as waste to be used by the plants again. Certain other bacteria convert some part of them to nitrogen gas, a denitrifying bacteria. As a result, the percentage of nitrogen remains the same. Fixing takes place, again the fixing, again the breaking takes place. So this cycle is on, and thus your the amount of nitrogen remains the same. I hope, children, you have understood this chapter. The summary of your chapter was provided to you. Tomorrow is your doubt clearing classes. Please get your doubt cleared by your respective teacher. Go through the video and the study material. Thank you so much.